Swedish band before. And it was his first time to do an interview. So he didn't know how to use the iPhone. There's this mic thing, and then it took us like 10 minutes to... I've never used it in the past, so it took us a lot of time to start the recording.
Yeah, and also to understand which was the right question to ask.
He had this long list of questions, and then he started. We started choosing the right question.
Exactly. And
next time we met was the second time we met was
in Stockholm.
In Stockholm.
Yeah. And in Stockholm was the time that we started to talk about the opportunity to do something together, but. We don't know in which way. So, but it was a good point to know that we want to do something together.
Yeah. So all that we decided was to do something together. And I think it was right after Christmas.
No, it was before
Christmas.
Yeah, because after you called me during that I was in the train station for to go to the parents of my girlfriend.
Oh yes.
So it was around 23 or 22 of December that you told me, I have idea which way we can do the collaboration.
Yes.
And he explained to me this tanka process that it's
the traditional Japanese way of collaborating. It's a poem, five sentences, and then the first person thinks about the first three sentences, and then he hands it on to the next person, and then you finish the story using the final two sentences, and it's finished. I started working on several ideas, like sketches, and then he started working on some sketches as well, and then we exchanged sketches.
After become a sort of ping pong problem.
Oh, yes.
not exactly. We start with this idea, but
I think that was the way we made the concept. We started with a single concept, and then the other person would finish the concept, right? And then the prototyping process, we would do this together.
After we discovered that around the bus there was a lot of people there.
A lot of journalists as well.
And after in Stockholm, of course, during
Stockholm Fashion Fair.
Yeah. And, but the was fantastic because the process for to develop the project was really natural without problem. So we don't have one thing that we discuss more than two times.
None of us knew what would happen in the end, what the final outcome would be, so it was kind of interesting. You start from an idea, but it really develops in a way that you really never imagined, so it's really exciting.
Yeah, I agree. It's a fantastic process, and one of the first things that we talk in Tokyo was about process, what we like about process. So to find this kind of collaboration that is in the process, and to find a new kind of process, was really nice.
In the initial phase, we didn't know how the entire collection would look like. We didn't know if it's going to be a collection or a single piece or not. After we started exchanging ideas, we had a sofa, we had shelves, things like that, and then we thought that we need a rug.
Yeah.
That's what we noticed in Stockholm, which was 1 month ago. And we said, maybe we need something like stools or tables inside the sofas.
And we designed this, but...
During the photo shoot.
Yeah, during the photo shooting, yeah.
the photographer said, pretend that you're sketching. And then we started sketching.
To work really.
So we finished the studio.
Yeah. So my opinion, both of us, we work a lot with many companies, and probably our way to do stuff is, of course, we have a lot of knowledge that during this period we developed to collaborate with clients. And also in our collection, I think the result is not to do a piece of art, but yeah, it's a real product that is also really important for us. And it was also natural in a way that in the end we discovered that this would be a collection and not a single piece. So, I don't know, but everything was a good alchemy and everything worked perfectly. We see 1 month, but for now, for now it's perfect. Challenge for me to show, I think, also to the design world that two designers can collaborate together and to do something also for fun, not only for but no, in the end, it's to discover that the friendship start to become stronger and stronger, so I think it's a lot of things that you combine together.
It's quite interesting that we were really friends when we started this project.
Yeah.
We just met for the second time.
Yes.
Now we're friends, so it's interesting. I was expecting the opposite to happen.
Tearing each other apart by the end of it.
So,
I guess collaborating is what we do. Many companies actually. It's not that we are artists and we ask them to produce what we thought of, but it's that we listen to what they are, I guess, what the brand is all about and which direction they're heading. And then we try to collaborate with them with respect to the techniques. And I guess what we did was exactly the same that you're doing this.
Another interesting point is that when we ask the company to support us and to develop the prototype, many of them was interested immediately to put in their collection the product. And we try to say, wait a little bit.
Wait for our exhibition.
Wait a
then.
Then we can. And it's funny because in the end we developed this project without a brief. So the company don't give to us a direction, so it was our idea. But in the end, they was more interesting in this than maybe if they give to us a brief, I think. Also, but I'm a design addicted, so when there are a super talented designer, really, it's impossible for me to say I don't like something. I really like the approach of working and everything. So it was a way also to see if my approach can combine with his approach. I'm really happy about everything. I don't have one.
About the flexible nendo means originals. It's flexible, freeform, and play. But so that was where I wanted to be in the end, to be very flexible. Because flexible is sometimes very difficult. Yeah. You start with so many clients, different projects. So when I started working with Luca, I noticed that he's super flexible. You know, problems happen, there's always small problems that we start creating things. There's so many different ways of solving problems. He's like a magician, like he has so many different pockets all over the place and so many different tools that he has. Stand and say, okay, we have a small problem here. And you say, okay, let me try this. No, it doesn't work. Okay, I have another tool over here. And then you so it's like, I don't know. It's
maybe I have a good pusher for this.
So it's about knowledge and the flexibility and the creativity.
Yeah, but it was, I think it was a perfect combination. And like in the end, I think. Of course, we are different, but we have so many points. It's the same, the way that we work. It was a fantastic. When we discovered that, it was wow, we have so many.